Hi everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another cylindrical coordinates example. In this example, we're given the cylindrical coordinates 2, comma, pi over 3, comma, negative 5. And those are cylindrical coordinates in the form r, theta, and z, as opposed to with rectangular coordinates where we always have x, y, and z. With cylindrical coordinates, we have r, theta, and z. So given that, we're going to be using these three formulas here to convert these cylindrical coordinates to rectangular coordinates. So the first formula is going to give us the x coordinate, the second formula is going to give us the y coordinate, and the third formula is going to give us the z coordinate of our rectangular coordinates, which will be our final answer. So once we have these formulas, and if we have them memorized or we have them in our calculator, all we have to do is plug in our cylindrical coordinates to find the rectangular coordinates. So remember we said that the cylindrical coordinate is in the form r, theta, z, which means we're going to be plugging in 2 for r, pi over 3 everywhere with it we see theta, and negative 5 for z. So you can see in this case when we're solving for the x coordinate, we're going to be plugging in 2 for r here, and pi over 3 for theta here. So this is the equation that we get for our x coordinate. For the y coordinate, we're again going to plug in 2 for r, and pi over 3 for theta. So the y-coordinate is 2 sine of pi over 3. And of course, we're going to be simplifying these. And then to find the z-coordinate, remember, we're just plugging in negative 5 for z. So z in our rectangular coordinate is also going to equal negative 5. It's the same in both cylindrical and rectangular coordinates. So this third coordinate here just stays the same. So z is done. We've solved for it. We have to simplify the x and y-coordinates, however. And the way that we're going to do that is using the unit circle. So the way that we do this is we're going to look at the unit circle and find the place on the unit circle where the angle is equal to pi over 3. So we head over to our unit circle and we're looking for pi over 3. So we start here and we're moving along the angle and we find here pi over 3. So this is where the angle is equal to pi over 3. Now for our x coordinate, we're looking for cosine of that angle. And cosine on the unit circle is the x-coordinate. So we look at the coordinate here, we see that the x-coordinate is equal to 1/2. So 1/2 is heading back over to our equation, what we're going to plug in for cosine of pi over 3. That gets replaced with 1/2. And of course, when we multiply those out, the 2's cancel and we get x equal to 1. Now to simplify the y-coordinate here, again, we're going to be finding pi over 3 on the unit circle and taking sine of that angle. So if we head back over here to our unit circle, again, we find the angle, pi over 3, and this time we need sine of that angle, which when you're looking at the unit circle, sine is the y-coordinate there. So we're going to be looking at the y-coordinate, and we see here that it's the square root of 3 over 2. So we're going to grab square root of 3 over 2, head back over to our equation, and plug in square root of 3 over 2 for sine of pi over 3. That's what it replaces. And of course, when we multiply that by 2 here, which we have for r out in front, the 2's are going to cancel, and we'll be left simply with square root of 3. So y is equal to the square root of 3. So now we have x, y, and z. And to find our rectangular coordinate, we just put the 3 of those together. So of course, we had x, y, and z, so our rectangular coordinate is going to be equal to 1, square root of 3, negative 5. And this is exactly the same place in our three-dimensional space as this cylindrical coordinate up here, 2, pi over 3, negative 5. It's just in rectangular coordinate form. And that's all we have to do to find rectangular coordinates. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next problem. Bye!